Hungary. Varna, me and my brother, we used to be kind of fans of some of the Bulgarian hardcore bands. So, and I was here once, even. So, it's an honor to be back. Yeah. Now it's in the summer. But last time was the winter, so it's way better now.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Before playing the next song, I would like to... You know that we are from Hungary, so I would like to introduce you to a little bit to Hungarian politics. We are not exactly like you are the typical political band, like raising our voices for every issue or whatever, but there are certain topics that we regard important. And for those we of course we stand for. And this time it's just like to spread the word or just to tell the truth about the Hungarian government and what are the circumstances that some of us or some of the Hungarian people have to live. So we in Hungary right now we have a right-wing government and it's constituted of a party called Fidesz, which is ironically having the Young Democrats party, and they are like these 60-50-year-old bunch of idiots, and they are in coalition with a Christian Democratic Party. So they have gone in power like a couple of years ago, and what is happening right now is really what is a bit like what we are afraid of. And probably you all as well here in the Balkans experience the migration of refugees or just simply immigrants who are looking for a better place to live rather than Iran or Afghanistan or whatever, like fucked up countries. And this situation and this chaos that was going on in the Balkans and also in Hungary was really well used by right-wing parties, right-wing governments. And right now in Hungary we are in a situation that, for example, last week, I don't live in Hungary right now, I live in Austria, but last week I went to see my parents and just had a glimpse on the TV what is going on. And the only thing that made me remember, that reminded me what was going on the national television, was all this Nazi propaganda that was probably going on before the World War against the Jews. It was exactly the same thing. About people that we don't know anything, we are supposed to have an opinion, we have to judge them, we have to basically be afraid of them, and that was horrible because most of the old people who are watching the national television in Hungary believe that thing, and they are afraid that they could be invaded or whatever. I don't really know what they are really afraid of. But what is horrible is that our country and our beloved leader, Viktor Orban, who you might have heard about, he is using this only to keep his power, to maintain his economy, which is probably is also really well known in Bulgaria, because I guess we are by now, Hungary is at the same level of corruption than like we are brothers actually now. We are just fucked up as well. A bunch of friends of the government, people in the government, are leaving our country. And they are having all the construction works, they are building all our roads, and we are just there and we are just watching it. And so this speech is as well is just like a reminder that if something like this is happening, people should raise their voices, people should go on the streets or just not, I don't know, like not pathetically listen to the bullshit and believe. And that shit was not happening in Hungary. It makes us feel a bit guilty as well, because we too are lacking the power to go like to go on the streets or whatever. And like I just wish that maybe some of you, if something like this is happening here, which is probably kind of like similar case, then you would do that. So yeah, I guess that was it. And I could, if you are interested about all these things, then you can come to me after the concert or to any one of us. They are not that shy when they are not on the stage, so they will talk to you. Yeah, so thank you, thanks for your patience. Really the concert with all the talking. And it's time for me to tune my guitar, so.